Well, you could say Joshua Sasse is living the dream. Right now, he stars alongside Susan Sarandon in the country music drama Monarch, which is due to drop on Paramount Plus tomorrow. So it's pretty hard to believe that just a few years ago, he considered giving up movies and acting for good following his high-profile split from pop princess Kylie Minogue. Sasse took a breath from Hollywood, he lived on a Greek island, and he even built an eco-lodge in Zambia.
Yeah, but there's a lot of parallels here. He married another Aussie, just like myself. He's now living down under with his family, just like myself. But unlike me, he's getting around in chaps these days. What was it like chapping up
Joshua
for your new role?
Joshua Sasse, welcome to the show.
Sorry, I was getting straight into it, yeah. You've chapped up for this brand-new country music drama, Monarch. What was that like?
Chafee.
Yeah.
yeah, it was good. It was good. I felt very macho, which goes against my normal persona. So playing against type.
What was it like working alongside Susan Sarandon? Sarandon?
Oh, I don't... I should... Susan, I'm so sorry.
You could say anything with that voice and get away with it.
I think it's Sarandon. It was quite distracting. You know, surreal. Because she's Susan Sarandon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it was amazing. And, you know, you saturate a lot and she's very still and calm and, you know, does a lot by doing nothing at all. And it's... Yeah, story, like you said, I was going to give up and I did walk away from it all. So to sort of find myself doing it again with her was lovely. Surreal, but lovely.
How's your love for country music?
Well, my wife is a really big country fan, yeah, and she's a massive Garth Brooks fan, and so when this came up, that was a big push to do it. There she is.
Ah, beautiful.
She's a Northern Territory girl, right?
She's an NT girl, yeah.
Yeah.
She's hard as nails. She makes me even softer. Look even softer than I am, which I don't need.
That's a bit sweet.
She's amazing.
Would love to hear a bit more about the family in just a moment, but I just want to go back to that breath from Hollywood that you took, because you did some interesting stuff when you were on that hiatus from Hollywood. Lived on a Greek island. You worked in a car garage, I think.
I did,
at one
building
point.
Vintage cars, yeah.
So right on.
What was it that made you go, all right, I need to step out of the noise?
I mean, I've been doing it for a really long time, since I was 15. So when all my friends were going to school and uni, I was working in the theatre and I was, you know, travelling, and I hadn't really stopped and smelled the roses kind of thing. And it just got a lot. And like you said, you know, I just split from Kylie and there was just a lot of attention, too much attention. And, you know, it's hard to be an actor when, if you're self-aware, is the death of it, because you then stop being honest or sincere, you know, when doing the character, because there's too much going on. So I just need to take a breath and, you know, try and work out who I was, you know. You learn a lot about yourself when the eyes of the world are on you. And sometimes, you know, not a lot of it you like. So you've got to just sort of... Well, I did anyway. And so I just went and did all the things that I wanted to do. I didn't know anything about cars. You know, if my car broke down the side of the road, and I got the opportunity to do it, and it's a bit like Lego, actually. It's not, it's not that difficult. It's just long, lots of nuts and bolts.
But what impact has that now and that perspective kind of had on your career now? Like, now that you're coming back, new eyes, it's like you're a new, I don't know,
a new
guy now. Yeah, but... Yeah.
No, a lot, because, you know, when you are working all the time, you don't get a chance to study people and watch people and, you know, be around real people because you're so rolled up in everything. So it was really good. And I think as an actor, you need to have all of that, and you need to have strings to your bow, and you need to have grounding and reality. And I've just been working for so long, I needed to come back to that, get some dirt under my fingernails.
And you definitely get a lot of dirt under your nails here in Australia. This is the place to be. Tell us about what your life is like here in Oz.
Oh.
With your little fam.
It's calm and it's beautiful. We live in Byron, and I hadn't been to Australia really before, and so my experience of it was just visiting my wife's family in Darwin, which, as a person from Wales, it was quite difficult because I was just sweating profusely. Which is not, it's not a great look. It's not very easy to look cool. So, and we went to Byron on holiday, and I was standing on the beach, and I was going, what is this place? I didn't know this existed. And, you know, this whale was surfaced there, and I was going, what's happening? And the more we were there, the more this stuff was going on, and it's just got a nice balance between being in nature but being around artistic... You know, it's got a really artistic heart, which meant a lot for me.
A bit different from growing up in Nepal with a snow leopard as a pet. Your backstory is so fascinating. We'll have to get you back on now that you're a local and you're one of us. But in the meantime, you can catch Monarch on Paramount Plus. It drops tomorrow. Head to paramountplus.com.au to binge. Joshua Sasse, thanks for being on our couch.
Best of luck and everything. That's awesome.
Thanks a million.
Love to the family too.